गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट सेक्शन 4 ऑफ फंक्शनल एनालिसिस। सो द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज ऑटोनॉमस सेट्स एंड सीक्वेंसेस। सो फर्स्ट वी डिफाइन व्हाट आर ऑर्थोगोनल सेट्स एंड ऑर्थोगोनल सीक्वेंसेस। इफ यू टेक एन इनर प्रोडक्ट स्पेस एक्स एंड एम इज एनी सबसेट ऑफ एक्स, देन यू सी दैट एम इज ऑर्थोगोनल सेट इफ इट्स एलिमेंट्स आर पेयरवाइज ऑर्थोगोनल। इट मीन्स फॉर एवरी टू एलिमेंट्स एक्स एंड वाई बिलोंगिंग टू एम, वी हैव द इनर प्रोडक्ट ऑफ एक्स विद वाई दैट इज जीरो। नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट इज ऑर्थोगोनल सीक्वेंस। इफ दिस ऑर्थोगोनल सेट एम दैट इज काउंटेबल, देन बिकॉज वी नो दैट एवरी काउंटेबल सेट कैन बी रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ सीक्वेंस। So if M is countable, in that case we can arrange it in the form of a sequence, and let us take that sequence is denoted by sequence xn. In this case the sequence xn that is called orthogonal sequence. In general if we take an indexed family denoted by x alpha, where alpha belongs to the index set I, we say that this family is orthogonal if every two alpha and beta belonging to the index set which are distinct, the elements x alpha and x beta are orthogonal. Means the elements of the sequence or this family, they are pairwise orthogonal. Next we define what are orthonormal sets and sequences. Let us take an inner product space x and M is a subset of x. Then if M is orthogonal, it will become orthonormal set if each element of this orthogonal set M has the norm 1. In general we can say that in an inner product space X, a subset M is orthonormal if for every two elements of M which are distinct, the inner product is 0 and the two elements are same, then the inner product is 1. If this condition is satisfied, then you say that the orthogonal set M is orthonormal. Next, we define orthonormal sequence. If the set which is orthonormal set, if that is countable, in that case we can arrange its elements in the form of a sequence, and in that case it is called orthonormal sequence. So in general, if we have the index family X alpha, then this is called orthonormal if it is orthogonal and all the members of the sequence has a norm 1. So in general we can say that inner product of x alpha and x beta that is equal to delta alpha beta. Delta alpha beta means Kronecker delta function, which is defined as if alpha and beta are different, then its value is 0, and if alpha and beta are same, then the value is 1. Now next we see some properties and examples of orthogonal as well as orthonormal sets. First property, as we already discussed, if we have two orthogonal elements x and y, in that case Pythagorean theorem holds for such elements. Means x plus y norm square is equal to x norm square plus y norm square. This property we already have discussed in the section 3. Now we can generalize this property for an orthogonal set. If we have an orthogonal set consisting of n elements x1, x2, x3 up to xn, in that case x1 plus x2 plus x3 up to xn norm square is equal to x1 norm square plus x2 norm square and so on up to xn norm square. Let us prove this property. So let us take the left hand side, which is summation xj norm square. Now by definition, norm square means inner product of this element with itself. We can take different suffixes j and k in this inner product. Now by using the properties of inner product, this can be written as the summation over j, summation over k, inner product of xj with xk. Now let us use the definition of orthogonal. If this j and k are different, in that case the inner product of xj with xk that will be 0. So one summation In this summation, we have only one element that will be corresponding to j is equal to k. So this will become inner product of xj with xj, and this summation over all j. By definition, inner product of xj with xj, that is xj norm square. So this proves the property Pythagorean theorem for the orthogonal sets consisting of the n elements. Now, next we prove the property of orthonormal sets. Every orthonormal set is linearly independent. This orthonormal set can be finite or infinite. We will prove the result for finite orthonormal set, because an arbitrary infinite set, we can say arbitrary means either that can be finite or infinite. An arbitrary subset of an inner product space is linearly independent if its every non-empty subset is linearly independent. So we will prove the result for finite subset. If that will be linearly independent, then the superset will also be linearly independent. So let us take a finite orthonormal set consisting of the members e1, e2, e3 up to en. We will prove that this set is linearly independent. So let us take a linear combination formed by taking the scalars alpha1, alpha2, alpha3 up to alpha n, and we consider the relation of the form alpha1 e1 plus alpha2 e2 and so on up to alpha n en is equal to 0. We will prove that all the scalars in this relation, they vanishes. Now, in order to prove this, let us consider the inner product by some fixed ej. So let us take ej is fixed, and let us take its inner product with summation alpha k ek, where k varies from 1 to n. Now, by using the properties of inner product, summation alpha k can be taken outside. Inside, we have inner product of ek with ej. Now, because ek and ej, these are the members of orthonormal sequence, so by definition, if k and j are same, this product will be 1. If k and j are different, then this product will be 0. So we get the value only when k is equal to j. So that will become inner product of ej with ej, which will become 1. So we are left with only one scalar, which is alpha j. Now, also the inner product of summation alpha k ek with ej. Now, substituting the value, summation alpha k ek, that is 0, and the inner product of 0 with ej, that is also 0. So all the scalars are 0. So this proves that the finite orthonormal set is linearly independent. And this also implies that if the given orthonormal set is infinite, in that case we also have the set is linearly independent. Let us see some examples of orthonormal and orthogonal sets. In three dimensional space of real numbers, the three unit vectors 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 which are in the direction of three axes of rectangular Cartesian coordinate system, they form an orthonormal system. Let us check it. So firstly, we'll check they are pairwise orthogonal. Let us find the inner product of these e1, e2, then e2, e3 and e3, e1. Now, in three dimensional space of real numbers, inner product of two elements x and y, that is defined by x1, y1 plus x2, y2 plus x3, y3. Now, let us find the inner product of e1 with e2. So, that will be 1 into 0 plus 0 into 1 plus 0 into 0, that is 0. In the same way, we can check the inner product of e2 with e3 and e1 with e3. Those are also 0. Now, we can check each element e1, e2, e3 that has a norm 1. Inner product of e1 with e1, that is 1. In the same way, inner product of e2 with e2 and inner product of e3 with itself, those are also 1. Thus, we can say that these e1, e2, e3, they form orthonormal set. Now, let us see an example of the sequence which is orthogonal but not orthonormal. Let us take an inner product space of real valued continuous functions defined on the closed interval 0 to 2 pi. Defined with the inner product of x and y by the integral of the product of xy over the interval 0 to 2 pi. We will show that the sequence un defined by cos nt, where n is 0, 1, 2 and so on. This sequence is an orthogonal sequence but not orthonormal sequence. So let us find the inner product of two members of the sequence. Let us find the inner product of un with um. Now, m n n can be different. They can be zero or they can be 1, 2, 3 and so on. So let us discuss the product in three various cases. First case we take when m and n are different. If m and n are different, then their inner product is given by using this formula which we are given. So by using the definition 2 cos a cos b, that will be cos a plus b plus cos a minus b. Now integrating and substituting the limits, we can see this inner product is 0. If m and n both are 0, in that case we get cos 0 is 1. So we get integration of 1 between the limits 0 to 2 pi. So that will be 2 pi. If m and n are 1, 2, 3 and so on, in that case we can see inner product of un with um, that is given by integral 0 to 2 pi cos square nt. Now doing the integration and substituting the limits from 0 to 2 pi, you can see inner product of un with um, that is pi. So we have, if m and n are different, then the inner product is 0. If m and n are 1, 2, 3 and so on, then the inner product is pi. If m and n are 0, in that case inner product is 2 pi. So thus we can say that the sequence is orthogonal sequence. But from here we can see that the norm of the members of the sequence, that is not 1 if m and n are same. So we can say the sequence is not orthonormal, but we can normalize the sequence by dividing the members by their norm. So if we define e naught by u naught upon under root 2 pi and en by un upon un norm, then this sequence becomes orthonormal.